means a lot for us because it's an appreciation that we received from a third party, as well as the fact that the client has given good feedback to everybody around and appreciated the effort that we have done in it.
Talking a little bit about the treasury, how has treasury management and technology, I mean, you know, changed over the last 5 years in the banks?
There is progress. I mean, like you know, they mentioned earlier, technology has been disruptive. We see that in our space too. I mean, things like blockchain and everything is entering our sphere too, and artificial intelligence is a new thing that we see, and we are looking as a company to see how we can incorporate that within our product so that we can serve our customers better. So that's an area that we have worked on. We've done some prototypes in both these technologies, and that's what we've been working on.
Well, and what has been your focus market?
Focus, I mean, we are a global company. We are present in over, and our clients in over 66 countries. We, you know, we do projects, we have clients, you know, across the spectrum as such, you know, from the US, right, to you know, Nigeria, India, you know, or, you know, we have a lot of presence in Europe. So it's a global company.
Yes.
We really are not looking at it from our market. We address all the markets.
Right.
Where we
So basically, there is no difference in how banks are using treasury management as solution.
No, it depends on the market in terms of what is the maturity of the market and what are the products that the banks deal with. But from our perspective, the product is the same. We don't have different products.
So what is that of treasury management in that space that the banks are looking at? You know, what are some new technologies the banks are looking at?
So what the banks typically are looking at these days is, you know, in addition to the business, is the regulatory compliance. That's a big focus in our areas, given the, you know, the recent upheavals that have been there. So that's an area we address really well. We have doing UMR, the margin requirements, BCBS, we have collateral solutions, and like I mentioned earlier, we are also started working on artificial intelligence and blockchain, and we have done prototypes of that, and we are looking to work with our clients to get a first implementation.
Can you tell us a little bit about how it impacts the, you know, the bank's performance in terms of financial performance?
So, you know, typically treasury is a very large part of the bank's P&L as such, you know, and it could be as high as 50%, depending on what the purpose of. So this is a core business in the bank. Treasury is not part of the bank. So what Calypso helps the bank is to streamline its treasury operations and manage the risk. So that's our focus. So how do we help our customers manage the risk and make money as a business?
How is 2020 looking like in terms of treasury management and overall global fintech trends that we can?
We see growth across all areas. You know, there are regulations that keep coming up, and we are continuously trying to address those regulations and help our customers. We see growth on the banking side, on the asset management side. We see a lot of growth in collateral management. We see a lot of growth in margin regulations, etc. And these are the areas that the company is focusing on and investing in.
Right. If you can, you know, throw some light on the challenges that the banks are facing in terms of treasury management, how Calypso is going to address those challenges?
So, the total cost of ownership is always a thing that banks. What does the bank look at is, you know, managing the risk. How do they do the settlements? How do they ensure that the settlements can be done efficiently and effectively? So That's where we are. What we can demonstrate to processing right from agency, right, processing, etc. So that there are more reconciliations later. And then the newer technologies, of course, will come and help them. We give them compliance checks so that they meet all regulatory requirements. So we address them in different areas, you know, depending on where the client wants it. And we have a single product which addresses all these products. That's the focus.
And to conclude, can you talk a little bit about your growth plans and any projections that you have for the Indian market?
So Indian market, we have been in the Indian market for the last 10 years or so. We see a lot of potential in the Indian market. We are looking at, you know, we are continuously addressing. We have, you know, quite a few clients out over here, and we are expanding, you know, trying to address the Indian market in terms of the local regulatory requirements as well as the local products.
Thank you, Mr. Uchil, for talking to IBS Intelligence.
Thank you.